from the SBI PO 2018 exam. These questions appeared in the preliminary exam, and all these questions are of the type quantity 1, quantity 2. We have to compare quantity 1 and quantity 2 and give the appropriate answer. In our first case, he says quantity 1 is x such that x square plus x minus 6 equal to 0, and quantity 2 is y such that y square plus 7y plus 12 equal to 0. All at the end it means is that you have to solve this quadratic equation, you have to solve this equation, and you will get two roots for the first one, two for the other one. Then we have to compare both the roots of the first one to the corresponding ones of the second one and derive a conclusion. So let us see how we can do it. We will start by factorizing both of them. Factorize this one. X square plus x minus 6 equal to 0. This can be factored as x minus 2 into x plus 3. From where we conclude that x is 2 or x equal to minus 3. We have two solutions for this one. Similarly, let us factorize the second quadratic expression. We will obtain y plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, factorizing this one. And from here we get y should be equal to minus 3 or y should be equal to minus 4. Now we have x as 2, x as minus 3, y as minus 3, y as 4. What is this? 2 is more than minus 3. So we can write x is more than y. This is our one conclusion. Is 2 more than minus 4? Yes. So this stays. Minus 3 and minus 3, they are equal. So we will put this one. Minus 3 and minus 4, minus 3 is greater. So this whole story stands. And therefore, x is more than or equal to y is the answer for this question. So you should compare each of the solutions to the corresponding of the second one and write and keep writing an expression here and wait for that to finally stand. If something went wrong here, then we might, let us say here it was minus 5 and minus 4, then natural, it's quite natural that it would have been x less than y here. We would have said there is no perfect relation between the two quantities. So the best is to start with first, compare it to each of the two, second, compare it to each. If you find some consistency, then that is the answer. In the next question, he starts by saying that A is 25% more efficient than B. He completes the work faster, 25% faster as compared to B. Quantity 1 he has given as X such that A can do 5/6 of the total work in X days. The time taken by A to complete 5/6 of the work, that is labeled as X. And similarly, 4/5 of the total work is done by B in Y days. We have to compare X and Y. We have to find out X, find out Y, and then make the comparison. Let us start with this hint that has been given to us. A is 25% more efficient means that if A completes that work in 4 days, then B will complete that in 5 days. 4 plus 25% of 4, this is equal to 5. So this is one starting point that we get. Now on the basis of this, let us try to see what will X be. So he says B completes 4/5 work in how many days? B is completing one complete work in 5 days. So he will complete 4/5 of that work in 4 days. So we have y as 4. And what about this one? A will complete 5/6 of that work in 5 by 6 into 4, which is 10 by 3 equal to 3, 1 by 3 equal to x days. So one quantity we have x equal to 3 1 by 3 and y equal to 4, and obviously y is more than x is the answer in this case. Let us move to the next question. In this case he says sum of 8 consecutive even numbers is S1. So any even numbers are there, any consecutive even numbers are there, and their sum total is given as S1. Okay. Quantity 1 is sum of 2nd and 8th number of this whole series. The sum of 2nd and 8th number is one quantity. Sum of 3rd and 6th number of the same series is the second quantity. We could start by writing any series and obtain that answer. That's absolutely possible. But we can make a small guess also. By inspection, we can see that the third number, these ones I am comparing, third number is 2 more than the second. Gap between any two consecutive even numbers is 2. So third is leading over the second one. So we can say this is 2 more. We can also see that the sixth number is 4 less than 8th. 6th, 7th, 8th. So you will have a gap of 4. So 6th of this one is 4 down. 3rd was 2 up. 6th is 4 down. So we will say overall this quantity will be 2 less as compared to the first quantity. So we can say quantity 2 is less than quantity 1 by 2 places. So instead of totaling and all, sometimes a common sense conclusion will also help you out. Now this is another question. An article is sold at rupees 1500 after allowing a discount of 12.5% on the marked price. So a shopkeeper has a marked price. He gives a discount of 12.5% and ultimately it is sold for 1500. Now first quantity is this figure of 550. The second quantity is the marked price of the article. Whatever is the marked price of article, that has to be compared with this 550. So we have to basically tell whether the marked price is more than 550 or not. No calculation is required. He has given the sale price as 1500. This sale price came after a discount from the marked price. This means marked price is more than 1500. And therefore, the marked price is more than 550. And without calculation, we immediately find out that quantity 2 is more than quantity 1, which is the correct answer. Let us move to the next question. This question says, if the speed of a boat is 500% more than the speed of the current. So you have a sort of boat here and there is a water current, and the boat is 500% more than the speed of the current. So it is more than, not 500% of, but it is more. So this means if the current is at 100 kilometers per hour, then the speed of the boat is 500 by 100, 500% of 100 equal to 600. Be careful on this one. Speed of the boat is 500% more than the speed of the current. Speed of the current is 100, then speed of the boat will be 600. So we should be very careful about this point. Okay, let's see what he says next. He says quantity 1, x, If the boat can travel a distance of 63 km in 3 hours downstream, then x is the speed of the boat in upstream. So a downstream distance is given to us. A downstream distance is given to us, and we have to access the speed of the boat in upstream. So upstream speed has to be compared with this quantity. Why? Whether the upstream speed is more than 15 or not, this is what we have to compare. Now we have already seen that boat is 6 times faster. The downward speed, the downstream speed will be 6s plus s, where s is the speed of the stream. S plus 6s, this downstream speed is given to us as 63 by 3 equal to 21. From where we can see that the speed of the stream alone is 3 kilometers per hour. So if the speed of the stream is 3 kilometers per hour, then the upstream speed, then what is the speed of the boat in still water? That is 6 into 3, 6 times this. Here we calculated it, so this is 18. The boat is traveling at 18 alone, stream is traveling at 3, and we have to find the upstream speed. Upstream speed means the speed will be the difference of the two speeds. So 18 of the boat will be resisted by 3 of the stream, and we will end up with 15. This 15 is equal to this. So we can say that both will be equal, and we can check up the calculation also. Upstream speed is 6s minus s equal to 5s. Opposed, 5s is given as 5 into 3 because s is 3 and 15, and therefore quantity 1 and quantity 2 are exactly equal. So these were the 4 or 5 questions taken from that exam. That is how you can do them. So we'll close it right now. Thank you.